Okay, today we're going to talk about modals of possibility, which I also call modals of certainty. I've got some graphs up here to show you degrees of certainty of some modals we're going to look at. First of all, what is a modal? A modal is a category of verbs in English. And these verbs have a couple of special properties. One property is that they always take the base form of a verb after the modal. Another property is that they do not have inflected endings, the S, the ED, the ING ending. So, for example, the modal must. Must will be followed by a base verb. Must have, must be, must do, must eat. And it never takes one of these endings. You never have must or musting. Okay? So, we're going to look here at some of these degrees of possibility. Let's look first at the present tense. And I want to talk about must, first of all, because this is a very misunderstood modal in English. A lot of people learning English learn that must is necessity. I must do this. You must do that. In reality, Americans today use must for that purpose, that necessity. Only in rare situations. It is usually in writing, and it is usually very formal, used for rules, for regulations, things like that. The majority of the time that you hear people using the word must in speech, it will be for a very different kind of purpose, and that is the idea of possibility or certainty. If you make a logical conclusion about something, if you have a reason to believe that something is true, you don't know for sure, but you have evidence. You have reasons to logically think that something is true. Then we often use must for that purpose. I've given it a 90% up here. You feel quite certain that something is true. It is commonly used when you are talking about how you think another person feels or what you think another person thinks. We don't know exactly how another person feels or thinks if they don't tell us. But if we want to guess at it, we use must. And this is quite common to use in conversation. Oh, you've been working 3 different jobs? You must be exhausted. It's a way of kind of identifying with another person or guessing what you believe they are feeling. Okay, so that's our present tense high-level modal for high possibility. In the negative, for modals, you want to use not after the modal. No other auxiliary verbs. Not don't or doesn't. We don't use that. So just the not after the modal. Must not. Can't and couldn't are very similar to must not. Negatives here. Can't and couldn't may be used a little bit differently, though. They are often used to say that you don't believe something is true, especially if you want to argue against another person or just say that you believe something is not correct. So if you are shopping and somebody tells you that the total for your groceries is $200 and you look at your groceries, you say, Oh, I'm sorry, but that can't be right. That can't be right is a very common expression to use to say you don't think it is possible for that to be true. In the positive present, we have may, might, and could, all with basically the same meaning, and that's about 50%. I'm saying with 50% that it is maybe yes, maybe no. You really don't know. You are not sure. You are just taking a guess. And if you are taking a guess at something and you don't know if it's true or not, you might use one of those. If you say, well, Susan might be at home. Susan may be at home. Susan could be at home. That indicates you really don't know. You are only guessing. 50-50 chance. The negatives, may not and might not. Now, notice there's no could not here because could not is used differently. It's used when you think that something is impossible. So be careful. In the affirmative, may, might, and could are all similar, but in the negative, could not is different from may not and might not. Okay. So we have similar idea in the past tense with must being about 90%. You make a logical conclusion about something. Can't and couldn't and must not for the negative. May not or may, might, and could and may not, might not for the 50-50 chance. To create the past form of a modal, you need to use the verb have in the base form because we need a base form after a modal. So you use the base form have plus a past participle. This should sound familiar. This is the same structure as a perfect verb, in a perfect verb tense. So we have the similar idea if you want to make a modal past. So you have must have with a past participle. May have, might have, could have, plus a past participle. Make sure that your past participle is that it's a third form of a verb that you learn. If you learn the verb eat, eat, ate, eaten, eaten is the past participle, okay? So all of these using have plus a past participle. In the future, there are a couple of differences you should notice right away. There's a difference that must is not here in the future. Instead, we have should. Should is used for your expectation, what you think will be true in the future, especially if you have a good reason to believe that that is true. So it is similar in idea to must. You really believe this is going to be true. It should be nice tomorrow. I heard the weatherman on TV or on the radio, and he said that the chances are very good it will be sunny tomorrow. It should be sunny tomorrow. The expectation. The negative would be shouldn't. We still have might and could down here at 50% and might not in the negative, but may is changed a little bit. That is a 63% possibility. Obviously, I'm just joking about these percentages. There's no actual percentage on exactly what percent you are sure of something. This is just to give you an idea of how sure a person is about a fact or an idea when they use these modals. So get the idea that may is a little bit more than might and could. Actually, when you use may for the future, really what you're doing is you're just emphasizing the possibility of something. Well, don't go now. The teacher may be coming. You have no idea if the teacher is coming or not, but you are emphasizing the possibility that the teacher is coming. So it's more for emphasis, really. So here are our forms. I have some sentences over here, a situation where I can't find my keys. I'm looking in different places. I'm thinking about the possibilities. There are verbs here in parentheses. You need to decide which modal verb would be the best. Is it present? Is it past? Is it future? What is the idea of how sure you are? And then create the correct form of that verb. Now, what I want you to do right now is stop the video, pause it, do the exercise, and then come back to me, okay? Pause. All right, did you pause it? Good, welcome back. All right, let's talk about these. I'm hoping you already have your answers. So, here's the exercise. First, I say, where are my keys? Let's see. They in my coat pocket. How sure am I? First of all, we're right here. We're in the present tense. We're talking about right now. I think I'm probably 50% here. I don't know where they are. It's just an idea. So you could use may, might, or could. They might, and then the base form. Might be. Other possibilities here are may be two words. This is different than one word maybe. This is separated, may be. Or could be. All of those are good possibilities. Okay? So they may be, they might be, they could be in my coat pocket. So I go check my coat pocket, look at it. Nope. Nope is a very informal way of saying no. Nope. Not there. How about in my bag? Did you put the same thing here? You should have the same idea. I'm still taking a guess. I still don't know. So, same three possibilities. Why don't I use a different one here? Okay. Again, you could also use might be or could be. Nope. Oh, I wonder if they're still in the door. It's very possible that I... Okay, now, what time are we talking about? I'm not leaving them right now. We just changed here to the past. So we need to look at our past forms here. Again, I don't know. This is just a guess. Oh, no, I'm sorry. I say it's very possible. That changes it. It's very possible. Although I don't have a true evidence to believe that this is true. This is just still an idea that I have. I don't know if it's true or not. It's just an idea. So I'm going to use these three Again, but now the past form. It's very possible that I might have left. Left is the past participle of leave. So might have left, or may have left, or could have left. All of those are good. It's another idea. It's in the past. So I go and I check the door. No. But there's a chance that someone, again, the chance that someone could have, past participle, taken, again, you can also use may or might. Make sure everybody's clear on that. Right? There's a chance that someone could have taken them out of the lock. Well, they, here, I believe that this is impossible because I remember locking my car with them. So now I have a reason to believe that this is an impossibility. It's an impossibility. I'm going to use can't or couldn't. They can't be in my car. They couldn't be in my car. Because I remember locking my car. Let me check my bag again. So then I go to my bag. And I'm checking my bag again. I can hear jingling. You know what a jingle is? It's that sound things, especially metal, makes jingling. So, I can hear jingling. Now I have confidence. I say they must be in here somewhere. And they are. Here they are. Okay, so hopefully that gives you an idea about these modals of degrees of certainty, degrees of possibility. Keep using them and remember especially these ideas of must and should and the difference of the negative can't and couldn't. And the affirmative could. Those are the ones that people get tripped up on. So try to remember those tricky ones. All right.